Let's give ourselves some practice substituting positive and negative values for variables. So we're told to evaluate x minus negative y, where x is equal to negative 2 and y is equal to 5. So everywhere we see an x, we could replace with a negative 2. Everywhere we see a y, we replace with a 5. So this is a y right over here, and then of course, this is an x. Let's do that. So instead of that x, let's write negative 2. So we have negative 2 minus, and then we have open parentheses, a negative y. y is equal to 5. Now what is this going to evaluate to? Well, this is the same thing as negative 2. Now subtracting a negative 5, so all of this business here, subtracting a negative 5, that's the same thing as adding a 5. So it's going to be negative 2 plus 5, which is equal to 3. This is going to be equal to 3. And there's several ways to think about this. My brain thinks, okay, I'm starting at negative 2. If I add 2, I get to 0. And then I would have to add another, and then I have to add another 3. So that gets me to 3. You could even view this, my brain kind of says negative 2. Well, let's see, I have to add 2 to get back to 0. And then I have to add another 3 if I want to add a total of 5. So this is going to be 0 plus 3 gets me to 3. Another way to think about it, negative 2 plus 5 is the same thing as 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2, which is of course equal to 3. Or you can of course draw it on a number line. And you would say if you start at negative 2 and you take 5 steps to the right, you get to positive 3. Let's do another one of these. This one's a little bit more complex. So let's see, we're told to evaluate 3 minus negative 6 plus negative h plus negative 4, where h is equal to negative 7. Well, there's two ways you could do it. I could just take the negative 7 and replace it, the h, with that negative 7. Or I could actually try to simplify this expression first and then do the substitution for h. Let's actually do that. My brain feels like doing that. So this expression, I have the 3, but instead of subtracting a negative 6, that's going to be the same thing as just adding 6. So 3 plus 6. And adding a negative h, that's the same thing as just subtracting h. So 3 plus 6 minus h. And then adding a negative 4, that's the same thing as subtracting 4. And now, of course, we can do this in any, addition and subtraction we have. We can change the order in which we do it. So let's do that just to kind of simplify all of this. So actually, first of all, I can figure out what 3 plus 6 is. 3 plus 6 is equal to 9. And then I have this minus 4 here. So I could say 9 minus 4. Actually, I want to be careful not to skip any steps. So 3 plus 6. In a color that you can see. So 3 plus 6 is 9. So that's 9 minus h minus 4. Now I could change the order in which I do this addition or subtraction. So this is going to be the equivalent of 9 minus 4. 9 minus 4 minus h minus h. And I just did that so I can simplify and figure out what 9 minus 4 is. 9 minus 4, of course, let me do this in blue and navy blue. 9 minus 4 is 5. So this whole thing simplified to 5 minus h before I even did the substitution. And now I can substitute h with negative 7. So this is going to be equal to, when I do the substitution, I'll write it up here, it's going to be 5 minus, I'll do the minus in that magenta color, minus, and now where I see an h, I'm going to replace it with negative 7. 5 minus negative 7. You want to be very careful there. You might be tempted to say, oh, I have a negative here, let me just replace h with a 7. Remember, h is negative 7, so you're subtracting h. You're going to subtract negative 7. So this is 5 minus negative 7, which is the same thing as 5 plus 7. 5 plus 7, which we all know is equal to 12. And we're done. Let's do a few more of these. You can't really get enough practice here. This is some important foundational skills for the rest of your mathematical lives. All right. So consider, I don't want to make you too stressed about it. Consider the following number line. All right, so we got a number line here, and they didn't mark off all the numbers here. This is -4, e is at this point. This is, then we go to 2. So it looks like we're counting by twos here, that this is -2, this is 0, yep. -4, if you increase by 2, -4, -2, 0, 2, 4, this would be a 6. This would be a -6. They intentionally left those numbers off, so we had to figure out that, hey, look, between -4 and 2, you have to go from -4 to 2, you have to increase by 6, and we only have 1, 2, 3 hash marks, so each of those hash marks must be increasing by 2. Well, anyway, now we know what all the points on the number line are. Evaluate e minus f. Well, we know that e is equal to -2, and we know that f is equal to 4. So this is going to be the same thing. E is equal to -2 minus positive 4. Minus positive 4. Let me do it in that same blue color. -4. Well, -2 minus 4, we have the number line in front of us. This is just going to be -6. If you start at -2, you subtract. If you subtract 2, you get to -4. You subtract another 2, you get to -6. So we are done. Let's do one more of these. Let's evaluate t plus negative u, where once again, t and u are on this number line, and it looks like each of these hash marks, we're incrementing by 3 as we go up. 0, 3, 6. And if we go down, 0, negative 3, negative 6. So it's clear that u is equal to 3. U is equal to 3. And it is also clear that t is equal to negative 6. T is equal to negative 6. So t plus negative u is going to be, so it's going to be negative 6 plus negative u. U is 3. You want to be very careful. You might say, oh, well, u is positive, so I'm just going to put a positive number here. But remember, it's negative u. Wherever you see the u, replace it with the 3. So it's negative 3. So this is going to be 6 plus negative 3, or sorry, negative 6 plus negative 3, which we can rewrite as negative 6 minus 3. All of this business could be rewritten as negative 6 minus 3. Negative 6 minus 3. If you're at negative 6 and you go 3 to the left, you go 3 more negative, you're going to end up at negative 9. And we're all done.